We want to use the graph of f of x and the graph of g of x to determine these function values. First, we have f plus g of 2, which using our definitions is equivalent to f of 2 plus g of 2. Now, to determine these function values, we need to remember that f of the input is equal to the output. We can also say f of x equals y. So we can think of the x value as the input and the y value or function value as the output. And each function value represents a point on the coordinate plane. To determine the value of f of 2, using the graph of f, we'll find the x value of positive 2, which notice would be here, corresponding to this point that has a y-coordinate or a function value of positive 3. So because this point has coordinates 2, 3, this is telling us that f of 2 equals 3. So if f of 2 equals 3, we'll have 3 plus for g of 2. We'll now use function g and find the point on the graph when x equals 2, which should be here. Notice the corresponding function value or y value is positive 1. So because g contains the point 2, 1, this is telling us g of 2 equals 1. So if g of 2 equals 1, this is 3 plus 1, which is equal to positive 4. Next we have f minus g of 3, which is equivalent to f of 3 minus g of 3. Notice here the inputs or the x values are positive 3. So going back over to our graph of f, notice when x is 3, this would be the point on the function that has a y-coordinate of positive 1. So because this is the point 3, 1, this is telling us f of 3 equals 1. So here we'd have 1 minus. Then for g of 3, notice when x equals 3, the output or function value would be positive 2. So again, this function contains the point 3, 2, therefore g of 3 equals 2. 1 minus 2 is equal to negative 1. Next we have f times g of negative 4, which is equivalent to f of negative 4 times g of negative 4. So looking at the graph of function f, here's where x equals negative 4. So when the input is negative 4, the function value or y value or output is positive 3. Again, this would be the point with coordinates negative 4, 3. So f of negative 4 equals positive 3, so we have 3 times. For g of negative 4, notice when x is negative 4 on g, the output or function value is negative 2. This point has coordinates negative 4, negative 2. Again, therefore, g of negative 4 equals negative 2. So here we have 3 times negative 2, which is equal to negative 6. And then finally, we have f divided by g of negative 3, which is equivalent to f of negative 3 divided by g of negative 3. Notice for f, when x equals negative 3, or the input is negative 3, the output or function value is positive 2. Again, notice this point here has coordinates negative 3, 2. So f of negative 3 equals 2 divided by g of negative 3. Notice for g, when x is negative 3, the function value or corresponding y value is negative 1. This is the point negative 3, negative 1. Therefore, g of negative 3 equals negative 1, and we have 2 divided by negative 1, which equals negative 2. I hope you found this explanation helpful.